Hi guys, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we will learn about rotating the bits of a number. Here, our task is to devise a mechanism for rotating the bits of a given integer, say n, by the number of bits given by the integer d. Now, first of all, the rotation can be either left rotation or right rotation. Here, we will see both of them. So, what do we exactly mean by rotating the bits? The concept of bit rotation is very much similar to the shift operation, except the fact that the bits that fall at one end are put back on the other end in the same order. Concisely, in left rotation, what we do is we left shift the given integer and the bits that fall off at left are again put back to the right side. And the same can be applied for the right rotation also. Let's understand this with the help of an example. For example, take n equal to 229, which has the given binary representation, and d is equals to 3. So, we need to left rotate n by the 3 bits. The output of the above example would be 47, which has the binary representation as shown. Now, let's understand how do we got this answer. First of all, the given integer can be viewed as that being divided into two parts. First consisting of the first 3 bits and the other containing the remaining 5 bits. Now, if we just left shift n by 3 bits, we would get only the last 5 bits, where the last 3 added bits are 0. So, if we want to make the first 3 bits as the last 3 bits, then after left shift, what we do is we first store those 3 bits at a separate place. And since we finally need to bring these bits on the right hand side, so we cleverly shift these bits to the right by the total number of bits minus d times, which is equal to 8 minus 3, that is 5 in this case. So, we right shift n by 5 and store the result in a separate block, which gives us the output which is same as that being shown above. Let's watch it more clearly. Here for the left rotation, we first left shift n by 3 and store the result in a variable named a. Then we right shift n by 5 and store the result in the variable b. Now we just need to combine those by taking the bitwise OR operation between them to get the final answer. The similar approach can be applied for the right rotation also. Here we first right shift n by 3 and store the result in A. Then we left shift n by 5 to store the results in B. And at last we combine both taking bitwise OR operation between A and B. Having understood this, let's go through the code for the rotation of bits. Here, for the left rotation of bits, we have a function named leftRotate which takes two integers n and d as the argument, where we need to left rotate n by the d bits. Now, we first left shift n by the d bits, and then we right shift n by int bits minus d number of times. Here, int bits is defined as the total number of bits in the given integer n. At last, we return the result of the OR operation between the two left and right shifted values to get the final answer. Now for the right rotation, we have a separate function named rightRotate, which rotates the given integer n by the d bits on the right hand side. Here, initially we right shift n by the d bits and then we left shift n by the int bits minus d bits. Now, at the end, we perform the bitwise OR operation between them to get the right rotated integer. Now going on for the complexity analysis, since here we perform just 3 operations, that is left and right shift of a given integer, and at last took the bitwise OR operation between them. This gives us the time complexity of the order of 1. Also, since our space remains constant throughout, that would give the space complexity of O(1). So, here we are done with the concept of rotation of bits. Thanks for watching. Please leave us your comments.